Okay, let's talk now about analytics. One feature that has been requested a lot to Android is the possibility of having like local, what we call local analytics. This is analytics based on the data that has been stored in your device. And maybe this data has not been synchronized with the server yet, okay, but it's in your device. And then we, when we talk about analytics, we are normally here referencing, for instance, pivot tables, or many table, or a chart, okay? So this is very challenging, as we may have some performance issues, and there are a lot of possibilities as well. So we, the way that we are like attacking this feature is like step by step. So this means that we are going to have like different Android versions that is that they're going to move ahead and having more like features for analytics. In this case, in 2.4, we are just centering in the scope is the enrollment. Okay, so we are centering in the at the TI level. Okay, so in 2.5, that's going to be released together with 2.37. We plan to expand the functionality of analytics, probably in 2.6, and probably this is going to take us the whole thing like probably 1 year and a half from now. So let's see how it works right now. So I'm going to open a tracker in this in the chat program. I'm going to open a TI here. Okay, and you see that now we have here a button. This is the analytic button, so you can navigate to the analytics. And what has been rendered, nothing new here, because we already in the previous version, we already could like offer here the feedback or the indicators. These are program indicators. Program indicators was working since a couple of versions ago, so nothing new here. But then we can see if we scroll down, we can see now the different charts, okay? In this case, this chart is representing how the weight evolution of for an infant, okay? There is a monthly basis, and you see how this is evolving. The next chart represents the height, okay? So how does this work? So what we are doing is like, whenever you have a program that has a repeatable program stage, we, in this tab, in the analytic tab, we are going to be able to render in charts or in tables, like all numeric data elements that belong to a repeatable program stage. So we can see how the values evolve over time, okay? Not only data elements, but also program indicators, which formula contains a data element that belongs to a repeatable program stage, okay? Like this is the case of the daily average weight, and daily is new child, but there are many other program indicators, okay? So here, this is the default behavior. So it will show all the possible combinations of all the data elements and program indicators that contains data elements of repeatable program stages. In the next 10 minutes, I'm going to show you how you can be more granular with this and have more control about the different charts that you would like to expose to the users. Okay, just only want to mention here that you can like change the chart type. If you click in these three buttons over here, this can change to, well, this, yeah, to a table, okay, and then you can navigate the values of the table. This can change to a bar chart, okay, but let me just go again to the, and value. Value means like it's going to, only going to, it's going to display only the last value, okay? So I'm going back to a line chart.